This is a demo of 41244, Nokia receiver, and it is not exhibiting any problems at this time. I like to involve the customer whenever possible, and so it's a lot easier for me to make a video like this, show you that it functions, and maybe it has an intermittent problem and it will show up in the future, but it has not shown up here after putting it on the bench several times and running it for several hours. So I'm going to explain what we're going to do here. This obviously is your receiver. In order to more accurately determine the quality of the audio, we're going to be able to hear it, but it's much more accurately done by viewing on this device here, which is called a dual trace oscilloscope. This is a low budget operation here. No cameraman. The upper display on this device is going to, show the left channel. The lower display is going to show the right channel. And above it is this horizontal black device, which is a distortion analyzer, power meter, give very accurate readings in decibels. And the two of those in conjunction are going to allow us to more closely examine the quality of the audio out of this. We're going to do two things. We're going to start off with a dynamic signal such as you would listen to at home, maybe on the radio. We'll listen to a tuner station. And then we're going to examine the audio with a 400 cycle sine wave, which is being fed to this item through a from a laboratory audio generator. And what's going to happen is if I turn the volume up too high, it distorts the microphone in this camera. So I'm going to have to switch over to what's called dummy loads as I increase the volume. A dummy load puts the same amount of stress on the receiver, but instead of converting the energy into audio, it converts it into heat. This way we can turn up an amplifier extremely loud, not damage our ears. Okay, and in this case, not distort the microphone on the camera. Now, in order to better see the oscilloscope, I'm going to swing the light somewhat away. The display will show it better. Okay, so we're going to turn your item on and listen to some radio, then look at a signal. And from your description, I understood you to say it does not come out of standby. Hopefully you can hear that. What we're going to do again is... Not sure what's going on here.
Why so serious?
That audio may distort at that higher level. What we're going to do now is switch over to a sine wave. Let's switch over to CD. Once again, I know I'm being redundant, but the upper traces your left channel, lower traces your right. I'm going to zero in on this, turn the volume up, and then we're going to switch the dummy loads. I can turn it and turn the volume up even higher. Hang on. There we go. Okay, I've just switched over to the dummy loads, and we're going to get some more gain here so we can turn the volume up even louder to a higher level. We're not going to hear it. Now we're getting to a dangerous right there where the sine waves, the top and the bottom, starts to flatten out. That's when we blow up the item. Your item has a protection mode which just kicked in. This is why the sine wave went down so much. Very nice design on this. It kind of prevents you from blowing it up. But as you can see, your item is functioning. It's functioned every time I put it on the bench. And I've got the item apart. This is what it looks like inside. And flex the circuit boards, heating and cooling with certain techniques we use to flush out intermittent problems. And that has not occurred as yet. So what we're going to do is send it home. And go back to some music here. Put it back together, send it home, and hopefully it'll fail. And you can bring it back, and it'll stay out long enough to find. But as of right now, I cannot fix something that does not exhibit a problem. I tap on the boards, I flex the boards, I heat them, I cool them. It does nothing. And all the curves you get in using my name. You think you broke my heart. Okay, that's the end of this.